I have the great pleasure now of being joined by Dr. Raman Muthusamy. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
I know that you are leading the AGA session on practical guidelines for the physician innovator. So tell me, who is the physician innovator?
Well, a physician innovator really could be any physician who's, you know, busy in the practice of seeing patients, sort of understands where we are strong and where we have gaps, and really identifying those unmet needs and figuring out solutions to sort of improve our care to patients.
I think it seems sometimes a bit overwhelming to think of yourself as a physician innovator. So what are the biggest challenges?
Well, I think that, you know, once you have an idea, I think many of us have ideas of how something might be done better. But the real challenge is, how do you incorporate that and really make that into a viable product or even a company when you have a day job, which is, you know, your physician practice. So, and again, as physicians, we're really not trained in sort of how to start companies or, you know, key initial steps in terms of protecting intellectual property. So we really need guidance on some of these areas, and oftentimes, unfortunately, since that's not in the past been typically available, many ideas may have never really come to see the light of day for those reasons.
Yet it's the physicians, I think, who are uniquely qualified to do these things because they are working every day and seeing what the needs are.
Exactly, and as you say, you know, many of the products that I use that on my daily care of patients now have been developed or at least came from the conceptualization from one of my colleagues in the GI profession. So so I think that there's certainly, we know best, you know, where we can make improvements, but the real challenge is, how do we take those ideas and make them come to fruition?
So for physicians who may have an idea or in the future come up with one, do you have any advice to try to implement that and take it further as opposed to letting it die on the vine?
Yeah, I mean, I think that you know, our session has really got a couple of physician innovators who have been successful and some of their stories in terms of how they've done this. One in particular works in an academic institution, and there's lots of issues with regards to intellectual property and, you know, the university versus the individual, which we'll get into. But we'll also talk about, we have a speaker who's representing industry and really will provide some information about how to make your pitch to industry, you know, in terms of do's and don'ts, in terms of intellectual property, what you should have done prior to your meeting. And we'll outline a variety of strategies that people can have in terms of the spectrum of how you can take your idea forward. You could license it to a company, you could start your own company, but then have a management team, or some physicians actually dive completely in and take a full-time role in taking their technology to the next level. So there's really a broad spectrum, and we'll sort of outline some different strategies that people may be able to use to figure out which may work for best for them.
Sounds like in this one setting, you're really going to provide a lot of practical advice, almost a tutorial.
That's our goal. I mean, certainly last year, I know this session was very well attended, and in fact, this year we've actually added a little reception afterwards, because many of the attendees may have specific questions that may be outside of the scope of the presentations, but still, you know, are worth addressing. And so we will have a reception, and hopefully our speakers will all be there to answer additional questions from our attendees.
Oh, that's terrific. So they'll get personal questions
answered.
Yeah,
exactly.
On a broader scope, why do you think it's so important for AGA to support GI innovation?
Well, I think that, technology, all of medicine is sort of moving forward through advances in technology, and certainly we talk about disruptive technologies all the time, things that completely change the way we practice medicine. And there's so many things in the 15 years since I've been in gastroenterology that are done very different than the way I trained due to new and better ways to do things. And so I think that really we need to sort of take the lead, and as you mentioned, really many of the best ideas of how to advance the profession are going to come from our colleagues who really see where we can move forward. And so having physicians take these ideas and then have them see fruition, one of the things that I've noticed is, you know, we're not engineers, and oftentimes for devices and things like that, we don't know how to make them, but the engineers don't know exactly what we need. And so it's very important for us to chat, and a lot of these ideas are really going to come from the physician. So I think it's crucial for physicians to keep thinking of ideas, and then when they get these ideas, we're trying to provide them a roadmap for how they can make them a reality.
And I think in practice, that's even more beneficial for the patients, and the more patients feel good about some of these advancements, the more they're going to come back for the care they need that will keep them healthy.
Absolutely. And we're trying to do things safer, more minimally invasive, and we've come up with lots of ways to treat diseases even that were previously did not have a great treatment. And within the last 10 years, we've come up with new techniques to treat Barrett's esophagus that came from a physician. We now have a much safer and faster way to drain pancreatic pseudocysts, which is again is another idea that came from a physician. So, we hope to continue to advance the field by, novel technologies.
And that's all encapsulated in the Center for GI Innovation?
Yeah, the Center for GI Innovation and Technology is a center from the AGA that really allows physician innovators and startup companies and their companies early on in their foundation to get advice on sort of key next steps, how to work with the FDA, how to get a product, regulatory approval, which is a big challenge, and then subsequently to be funded by insurance carriers so that they actually can sort of advance in the marketplace.
Well, thank you so much. Looking forward to the session where you will be empowering physicians to be physician innovators.
Great. Thank you very much.